Hi everybody, this is Laura, City Scrapper. Thank you so much for joining me for this video today. Today I have a layout that I made using the September My Creative Scrapbook Limited Edition Kit. Clearly this is an older layout, but I wanted to share my process and my layout with you. This is of course not the current My Creative Scrapbook kit, but there's always a beautiful kit available from My Creative Scrapbook. This is the limited edition kit. This is my personal favorite, but there are four gorgeous kits available each month. And if you're interested in checking them out, you can look in the description box. There's a link to a page where you can view all of this month's kits and purchase them. I started off this layout with the stamps that were in the kit. These are Hampton Art stamps, and they're those layering stamps where you can create more depth and more dimension by adding additional layers of stamping. I'm using three different colors of Distress Oxide. I'm using Spun Sugar, Kitsch Flamingo, and Barn Door. I don't stamp with different colors all that often, so this was something that was kind of new to me. I really, really love this larger rose. It has so much dimension to it. I just love the way the different colors of ink make the rose look so detailed. So I stamped a whole bunch of the large roses and the smaller roses, and then I inked the edges, and I used Distress Oxide in Victorian velvet to ink the edges. And you could see there to the left of the layout, I also have quite a few fussy cut pieces from the pattern papers of this collection. And the collection that was featured in the September kit was the Prima My Sweet collection that was designed by Frank Garcia. I always love the colors in his collections. This collection has some beautiful shades of pink and green. I started making a wreath with the largest roses that I had stamped. I'm popping up some of the roses and I'm attaching some of them down directly to the paper. I wanted to create a structure for the wreath, but I'm going to add a lot of other elements so that it doesn't just look like a whole bunch of the same rose in a circle. You'll see that in a little bit. So now I have that first layer of roses attached down. And then I add some of the other large roses that I had left over, and I'm tucking those into the wreath. And then once I had this outline of roses, I cut it out. I wanted to be able to move the wreath around because I was thinking that it would be nice to have some kind of media on the background. I'm going to end up using some modeling paste, and I didn't want to add it to the paper when the flowers were already on it. I wanted it to be a separate piece of paper, so I cut it out both around the outside edge and the inside edge. Once that was cut out, I started adding more flowers to it. So I'm cutting some of the flowers in half because, of course, you won't be able to see the whole flower, and I wanted to conserve on flowers since I used quite a few of them to make this wreath. I started off with just a very simple, very regular circle of roses, and I want to make it look a little more irregular at this point. I don't want it to look so perfect. I want the roses to look clustered and a little asymmetrical. So that's what I'm doing now. I'm adding some flowers around the outside. I'm layering them and trying to make it look more realistic by making the edge a little more textured and not so round. I've used up all of those large flowers, and I think I have enough of those on this wreath. So now I'm working on placing those smaller flowers on the layout. And I'm tucking those around the outer edge and just using some ATG adhesive. I like that adhesive because if I change my mind about the placement, I can just go back and reposition any of the flowers. I add the last few of the smaller roses to the wreath, and I believe that I stamped a couple more of the large roses to fill out the whole wreath. I'm going in now with the fussy cut roses, and I like the way this adds another color of pink and then also some green to the wreath. I also like the way the flower is a different size because I have so many of that very large flower, so I think that it makes sense to have a different size flower mixed in. I'm spreading them around. Some of them I'm tucking under the other flowers. Some of them I'm putting along the edges, some in the center. I'm just trying to make the wreath look pretty, and I'm just kind of going with what I think looks nice in the moment. Then I emptied out a little bag that I had made of a whole bunch of the flowers that I had fussy cut from different papers. There were a few buds and leaves that I thought would look pretty on the layout as well. And now that I'm looking at those pieces that I emptied out on the right, it seems like many of them were roughly cut out, but I used the ones that I had fussy cut out on the wreath. And this looks a little odd, but I'm making sure that all of those pieces are attached down. And then I use another flower to fill in a little spot on the right of the wreath. And I could go on all day tucking these little florals into the wreath, but at some point I finally decided that it was time to add some butterflies. So I love these butterflies. They are a different color than the pinks and the greens that are on the layout so far, so I thought that this was a nice addition of color. So I added three butterflies around the wreath. I wanted to add a little touch of yellow to the wreath. I found that in the collection, there was a tiny, tiny hint of yellow, and I really liked the way yellow looked with the rest of these colors. So I use a very, very small punch that was in my stash. It's a punch-a-bunch punch, and I cut out a whole bunch of these very, very tiny flowers. I glued down some extremely small pearls to the center. I had ordered these pearls a while back. I think that they were really meant for manicures, but they were so tiny and just perfect for these flowers because these are pretty small. But I just liked the pop of color that they gave this wreath. I think that they really brought it to life. So I used some yellow paper and then I inked the edges with some fossilized amber distress oxide. Now I'm going to be working on the background. I'm using a piece of heavyweight white cardstock. I have gessoed the background, but I don't necessarily think I needed to gesso it, but I always gesso just in case I decide to add something more than what I planned. I'm using the Vicky Booten stencil that was included in the September kit, and I'm using some modeling paste, and I'm creating a textured dot background. The wreath is extremely busy. There's a lot of colors on it, so I think that it would be best to keep the background white. When I don't think it's a good idea to add a lot of color, sometimes I will just add some texture. So that's what I'm doing now. And I really like the way this looks. I do think that it added a little something extra to the background. And the wreath covers up a lot of this texture paste, but you can see the dots and the texture all around the edges of the wreath and even a little bit on the inside of the wreath when the layout is complete. Now I'm creating a border for the background. I'm using some 1/2 inch strips of paper. I've already created a number of layouts using this kit, so I have a lot of small strips of paper that I've cut from some of the papers that I already used. The branding strips are 1/2 inch, and that's what always makes me choose 1/2 inch for the strips of paper. I take a piece of heavy white cardstock and I put down some ATG adhesive, and I'm arranging the strips in a way that I like. And I really talk about this all the time, but I love putting strips of paper from the same collection next to each other like this. I think it brings out the beauty of the whole collection in a very small area. So I took that strip of paper that I made and I cut it into 4 strips. I'm using a piece of paper to anchor everything. And I'm attaching 2 of the strips down on the right and the left, and I just leave those as is. For the top and the bottom strips, I fold the corners down, and then I cut along the fold lines, and then I use the strip that I've already cut to use as a template for the other strip, and then I attach those 2 pieces down, and that creates a little bit of a frame look around the layout. And I apologize for this terrible lighting. I have since mostly solved this problem that I had where the light would flood the workspace, but back then I had the wrong lights for what I was doing. I have since learned what to do, not saying that all of my filming will be perfect from now on, but the lights are more appropriate for this area. So I put a lot of ATG adhesive on the back of that paper, and I attach it down to a piece of green paper, and I just pull that color from the pattern papers, and I make a thin border of that green around the textured modeling paste background. And now I'm going to attach that piece down to the frame that I just created with the strips of paper. So this is the background for the layout, and this is where the wreath is going to sit. I placed a chipboard blue butterfly on the bottom of the layout. I don't end up leaving that butterfly there. Now I'm creating some embellishments for the four corners of the layout. I didn't want to have a huge amount of white space without a little something for you to look at, so I cut some right triangles from the pattern paper, and I'm attaching those down in each of the corners. Once I had those four corners attached down, I pulled out another piece of chipboard that doesn't make it onto the final layout, that birdhouse that's on the left. And then I was thinking maybe I would put some of these small yellow flowers on each of the corners. But then I decided that I was going to put some roses on them. So I had some that were already fussy cut out and some that I had roughly cut out but hadn't finished cutting them out. So I completed that, and then I put one rose on each of those corners. Then I inked the edges of all of those flowers, and I'm using the dauber, and the dauber has some Victorian velvet distress oxide on it. And earlier I also used that dauber to ink the edges of all four triangles. I pop all of those flowers up using some fun foam. I've added my photo of both of my daughters, and I'm adding my title, and it's going to be called Sweet Memories. I mount my photo on some thick white cardstock, and then I mount it again on some green cardstock. This is the same color that I used in the background. Then I tuck it into the wreath. I put it on a slight angle, and then I put together these two words, sweet and memories, and that will be my title. I cut a little fishtail in the paper around the word sweet. And I want my photo to be attached down to the page before I attach the title. So I use some fun foam and I piece that together. I'm using a bunch of different scraps that I had in my stash. And then I use some ATG adhesive to attach that down to the layout. There are a lot of different adhesives you could use on this foam. I like the ATG because I can move things around, and that works on the foam as well. I ink the edges of both the word sweet and the word memories, and I pop up the word memories on some foam. Since the photo is sitting on some foam, I need to put some foam behind the word memories as well. And then I do the same thing to the word sweet, and I actually put a double layer on the word sweet so that it will sit up as high as the word memories. And this photo was taken of both of my daughters several years ago when we went to Cape Cod. And I really love this photo. I love the way my daughter Julia on the left is resting her head on Danielle's shoulder. It makes me so grateful that my girls are close and that they get along. It is time to attach that wreath down to the background. And of course, there's modeling paste on the background, and I want to make sure that it stays put. So I put quite a lot of the ATG adhesive on the back of it, and now it is in place. To give a little bit of extra dimension to the butterflies, I put some of the fun foam on the back of those as well. And I switched the place of one of the orange butterflies and that teal butterfly. I add a self-adhesive pearl to each of those corners that I made earlier. I thought about adding pearls to all three corners of the triangle, but then I changed my mind and I decided that I was just going to add the one pearl to the outside corner of each of them. One of the things that I love to add to my layouts is die-cut floral pieces. These are branches. They look like they have little buds on them. I cut them out in white because there's already a lot of color on the layout, but I did want to add a little bit of shine to them, so I coated them with some Bow Bunny glitter paste. I like the way this dries very quickly, and it adds a nice shine to whatever you put it on. And of course, you can buy glitter paste in different colors. This one is clear. It's called Sugar, and I think it's really handy to have one that's clear so you can change the look of pretty much anything and add a little bit of glitter to it. I'm cutting these die cuts into smaller pieces. I don't want any large branches on the layout, but I like the idea of adding little touches of these buds all around the layout. I continue trimming and adding these white branches around the layout. Once I'm happy with where I place them, I use a little bit of gel glue and I glue them all down to the wreath. I wanted to add something with a different texture to the layout, and I love adding pearls. The other pearls that I added to the layout, those are self-adhesive, and they are, I guess, a half pearl. These are round pearls, and I have them in this beautiful green color that I thought matched the layout very well. It matched the pattern papers, and I have it in a couple of different sizes. I scattered them around the layout, and then I went in with some gel glue, and I attached them in place. And that is the very last touch that I add to this layout. Here are some close-ups. I hope that you enjoyed this video. I really enjoyed making this layout. I enjoyed using the stamps. That's something that I think I should do more of. I want to say thank you to everybody who watches my videos, likes, all my subscribers, old and new. And even if you're not a subscriber, thank you for watching. And I want to just give a special shout out to all of you wonderful people who leave me comments all the time. I can't tell you, I might just write thank you, but each comment means so much to me. I appreciate your taking the time to do that. The link to my creative scrapbook is in the description box. I hope you all have a great day. Take care. Bye-bye.